So, adult cartoons certainly are back in full force these past couple years, and with the Rick and Morty fanbase's reputation being totally in the toilet, and with things like Big Mouth getting all kinds of unjust praise for being run-of-the-mill, I thought I'd share with you some cartoons that I think need a lot more love.
Previously on a very special Clone High. This is a really long episode, so I'm gonna go fast. Joan likes Abe, Abe's dating Cleo. It's a crazy love triangle. Let's start the show.
Clones of historical figures attend high school together. A parody of teen dramas, Clone High hits every trope and cliche and parodies them mercilessly. The comedy comes in both zany physical gags and dialogue dripping in self-awareness.
I understand. You sold us all a bill of goods, and those goods turned out to be bad. Then you sold me up the river.
That may be, but I sent you up that river with my heart as a paddle.
But you took that paddle and smacked me in the face. And I wear my heart on my sleeve, so when I wiped my face, I got heart all over it.
Every plot is a cliche taken up to 11, hence surpassing the cliche and becoming something else entirely. The jokes range from intelligent to lowbrow to absurd. The cast is great. Line reads themselves can get really funny. The animation is also really fluid and energetic, which isn't too common for adult shows.
Where the hell is the candy?
Where'd mommy go?
She's out shopping.
Yeah, for a new husband.
She is not! Did she say something to you? Stupid goddamn kids! There it is!
Trick-or-treat!
Oh, look at that, Fat Albert.
I'm not wearing a costume!
Well, then you don't get any fucking candy.
This show follows the everyday lives of the Murphys, a lower middle class family living in the early 70s. Frank is a Korean War veteran who gave up his dream of becoming an airline pilot to raise his son and quickly marry his girlfriend due to her unplanned pregnancy. The show is far more subtle compared to its predecessors such as The Simpsons or American Dad. It's more comparable to like early seasons of Roseanne or Married with Children. The show has a slow, more realistic pace, focusing on everyday aspects of life, heavily character and relationship-based. But don't get the impression this show is quiet. The arguments, for example, are highly volatile and realistic.
Oh, I knew you wouldn't support me!
I'm getting a hernia supporting you! But this part-time job is out of control! You're not paying enough attention to your family!
Well, at least I'm not screaming at it!
Oh, it's called having emotions, Susan, alright? Christ, you're ice cold! Like those fucking TV dinners we've been eating every night! I haven't had a decent meal in weeks, okay? Today was probably the worst day of my life. We're probably gonna have a strike, which means the whole company goes down at Christmas. And I had to kiss Vic's ass, that fucking gigolo, to get tickets for our son who we now have to treat like a fucking Danish snowflake!
You know why we do that. You know why.
Oh, God, are you really gonna bring that up again? Kevin was only down there for 2 minutes.
2 minutes, Frank, at the bottom of a motel swimming pool.
Look, just because you drown a little bit doesn't give you an excuse to be an asshole for the rest of your fucking life.
He's trying. He's really trying. And you wouldn't notice because you're too busy riding him. Discipline Bill, do you? It's never Bill.
Bill can't.
It's always Kevin.
That's because Bill's a little pussy. Christ, he falls apart if you just look at him, all right? He's got no spine. You gotta rub his back during war movies. He's scared of everything. Gee, I wonder where he got that from, Susan.
What do you mean, he gets it from me?
You coddle him too much and you know it. You know it.
I work hard to keep this family happy. I keep everyone from killing each other.
Well, today, I would actually welcome it.
You are a horrible, rotten human being.
The strengths are definitely the writing, the character and dialogue-based humor, and the subtle but unpredictable storylines.
Dodd, my teacher says that every bod experience teaches us a lesson.
Ajax, your teacher is wrong. It's had no lesson at all. It's impossible for any thinking person to come away with any new insight whatsoever. I want you to make a detailed list of everything that happened. So if this situation ever comes up again, we can do exactly the same thing we did this time and keep our fingers crossed that it turns out better. Who wants cake?
Duckman, Private Dick / Family Man, follows Eric Duckman, a put-upon private investigator and recently widowed husband and father. Along with his dry-witted and multi-talented partner Cornfed, they solve... well, Cornfed solves them anyways. This relic of the early 90s is often described as ahead of its time, although I find it to be very much a product of its time, with perhaps a little more freedom than the average network show. This description likely has to do with the fact that many of the issues satirized in Duckman are still relevant, if not more so today. Duckman is a fast-paced action comedy slash family bastardization of a sitcom. Duckman's personality leaps off the screen, and the comedy is quirky and strange enough to not feel stale, even after such a long time. I personally find the stylized art and fluid animation to be a large strength as well.
I hate myself.
Why do you quit working on me?
She always fools me, Aura.
I'll make things better, dear. Drink me. Put me inside you. I'm great. And she chokes me just like every other whore out there. They're all worthless, kid. Every woman. Don't let them get you. All of them want to get you. They just grab you and pull you into them. And you're forced to stay in and pull out. Stay in and pull out. And then they got you. And they grip you by the right where it counts. And then they start squeezing things out. Things that are like weights around your head. You sit there for the rest of your life with nowhere to go and no one to be.
A stop-motion deconstruction of small-town Christian America, the series follows Oral Puppington on his quest to be a good Christian. Basically, the show plays on the idea of the town's populace seeming perfect at first glance, but slowly, or sometimes not so slowly, we see the facade slip. Season 1 mainly follows a simple episodic formula with very broad humor typical of Adult Swim, at least at the time. Season 2 is where the more realistic tone and character-based plot sets in. Season 1 sets it up, however. By season 3, many consider the show to be too good to succeed. But really, when you compare season 3 to season 1, it's really not too hard to see why Adult Swim was like, whoa, this is not what we signed up for.
You're young like me, so you must be my mom. I mean, why couldn't you just live with us? This candy's good.
Your dad just thought it would be best if I lived alone.
Those guys are pretty stupid, right?
No! Well, not all of them. Especially my Sonny. He's really smart. He goes to school and is in the play at the school, and then some other stuff.
Big deal. So was I. He's not so special.
Ugh. Yes, he is.
No, I hate him.
Ugh. Again, this is a show that does a great job telling smaller stories.
Atomic Comic Collection Connection. You're
Shut
online.
Up, I know. What are you doing?
Working. Oh, hang on. Atomic Comic Collection Connection. You're online,
21.
Boss.
This is the Monarch
Holy
speaking.
Crud. I got 24 in the other line. I'll put us on three-way.
Good.
I
have Want to hear this, too.
Dude, it's the Monarch.
Hey, boss. How's prison?
Well, I'm out. No thanks to you schmucks. Guess where I am now?
At a good friend's house?
I am sitting in the charred remains of my once mighty flying cocoon. Anyone wanna explain to me why my cocoon is charred?
Because you told us to destroy the cocoon.
And why it is sideways.
We're following orders. You can't yell at us for following orders.
Or kill us for following orders.
This action-adventure sci-fi comedy show started as a send-up to Johnny Quest-type shows of the 60s and 70s, though by the second season it really became less of a parody and more of an entry into the genre itself, only with copious amount of effort and talent actually put into it. If you like character development, stories that unfold sporadically throughout seasons, weird, unexpected characters being killed off or becoming super relevant, then this is the show for you. Venture Brothers is the type of show you have to watch a few times to get everything out of an episode. Rarely is anything spelled out to the audience. This is a show that loves subtext and referencing previous episodes without, you know, having to do a reminder beforehand. Though, just a warning, the first few episodes don't do a great job drawing the viewer in. I find most first-time viewers don't really start to enjoy the show until Midlife Chrysalis or Eeny Meeny Miny Magic. Also, don't start with the pilot. It's non-canon, and it'll probably just confuse you. Hey guys, thank you for watching this video. If you liked it, just go ahead and give it a like, leave it a comment. Maybe consider subscribing to my channel. I'm going to be doing a lot of like video essays and reviews and type of stuff like that. So if that's what you're into, and also more like cartoon videos. So if you want to see that, like subscribe if you want.